two blocks today. Have them at the top of your mat. And then let's start. So I don't think this will be super traditionally taught, but just a quick breathing exercise. I believe it's called the bumblebee breath sometimes, but just to bring your focus in and make you more aware. Three fingers, cover the eyes. Thumb, lightly press in the ear. And then just start to take a couple deep breaths in through the nose, out through the nose. And what you're gonna notice is that it's almost echoed, it's almost amplified. So to me, even while talking, it sounds kind of strange. Just very lightly press the ear in and start to take a few deep breaths in through the nose, out through the nose, and see if you can feel the awareness kind of being dragged in a little bit more. And we'll meet up in roughly 10, 12 deep breaths. I'm on about 7 here, but you can keep going, you can pause me, you can do this for a little bit longer if you want. But I'm gonna start the music. Today we've got some twisting. And so for me, the twisting, I use the blocks because the ground is too far away for me. But again, if you don't have blocks, it's okay. You can use a set of weights even and hold them on their tall side. Also, if you follow me on Spotify, I'm using my Yoga Flow 25 mix. So you are welcome to use that as well. The music I'll probably, pause. I'm not gonna use any music because I'm recording this and I don't wanna get in trouble on YouTube. So it looks like I'm not using music for this practice, which is okay. Now taking your shins, pressing them slightly out from your center, go ahead, flex the feet, and you'll notice it just kind of sharpens the edges of your legs a bit more. If your feet are relaxed, your legs kind of go a little bit limp. If you press out through your heels, through the balls of your feet, almost like you're in Tadasana, it just brings a little lift. If it's too much of a lift, if your knees are up here, you're gonna sit onto a block. Actually, I might sit on the block anyway, it's more comfortable. So the knees are sloping gently downward. With your right hand, take it up to the side, sit tall. Turn your thumb down, and then you'll thread your arm up right between the shoulder blades. And I'm going to dig in kind of with the pinky side of my hand and attempt to squeeze the back side of the shoulder blade to open my chest in the front. So now as you're breathing, you're getting a slight stretch here in the front of the arm. The wrist might get a little bit tender, so you can just keep breathing your exhales into that general area where it's tight. Inhales, try to lengthen up a bit more. And so we're opening the shoulder girdle and across the front of the body a little bit. And again, as you breathe in through the nose, out through the nose, try not to lose any height as you're here so that you can stay lifted. And I mean, this is the bottom half of your Gomukhasana arm, but it's early, it's out of the gates, just out of the gates, so no need to jump into it. And then when you release, let your neck relax, give the arm a big circle, swim around, and we'll switch sides. Left arm goes out, thumb turns down, and you can kind of start, I lay the pinky side of my hand there first. Actually, you can cheat with your opposite hand. And if you press into the outer edge of the palm, it helps you kind of press in between the shoulder blades like you're karate chopping, so you can open. I teach here in Japan, and when I said, karate chop your blocks today, everyone started laughing. It was really funny. I guess the reference to Japan or thought was amusing. Again here, squeezing backside of the shoulder blade to open the chest. A few deep breaths. Notice that the feet have kind of gone limp. Press like you're pressing into blocks on the side of the feet so they stay active. Just take another breath here. And then releasing the arm, we can circle the arm up and around. And let's bring ourselves into cat-cow. So knees under the hips, fingers spread wide, and my hands are under my shoulders. Inhale to arch. Exhale to untuck the toes and round. And even more of an arch and round, what you want to think about is your tail kind of lengthening back and up to inhale. And then the exhale is the toenails pressing down. Is the tail starting to point towards the backside of the knees as you scoop your belly? And then again, just one more inhale to arch. And exhale to round. Finding now a neutral spine right in between. So without moving anything else, I'm just going to press my right heel back. Notice it's not super high. My abs are tight, so it's just a little lower than hip height. Hopefully, and then rotate your toes in and down so your leg is parallel. Left arm, take it out to tabletop. So already you might feel a bit wobbly. Keep the leg low, keep the abs tight, and then you can start to thread your left arm through to the right, bending the elbow slightly. And then of course, if you're comfortable, you can go more and more. Exhale to come up. Inhale to thread the arm through and come down almost to the side of the face. Exhale to rise up. Just one more. Inhale to thread the arm through. Exhale to come right back up. And we'll just take one elbow to knee. Exhale to round, scooping the belly. And then inhale to reach out. Now bending your back leg, you'll reach for the ankle. Here's a quad stretch. So you might be like, I'm okay here. Or you might tighten your abs a bit, lengthen out, and then start to lift the chest, press the leg back, and you get a little chest opening light stretch. One breath in. Exhale to release, and then take the other side. So left heel presses back, the leg gets nice and long. Right arm goes out to the side. Breathe in, breathe out, and on your next inhale, sweep the arm under. You're threading it to the opposite side, slow. Exhale, pressing into the fingerprints, the heel of the hand to rise back up. Notice you're not taking the back leg with you, but it's actually staying pressing long. So the heel is pressing back behind you, almost like you it was in like an Ardha Chandrasana. And on your third one here, as you come up, you're tightening your abs right away so you can find a neutral spine, lengthen the arm forward, and on the exhale, pull knee to the nose. Inhale to press out. And then again, give the back knee a bend, reach back for the ankle, which might be hard already, so you might just kind of stay. Feel your center pull in. Or lengthen the knee, the head forward, the knee back, and then begin to arc and look slightly up. Stay for another breath. And then release to your long line. Hands return down, press back, child's pose. Toes together, knees apart. And then rolling up, send your elbows back as you parallel your shins and you're coming halfway down chaturanga. Press right back up, child's pose. So it's a modified chaturanga. Your knees are down the whole time here, rounding to come up, adjusting the legs, elbows pull in and back as you lower halfway down. And then press up. Notice that your neck is staying long. It's in line with the spine. So that as you're coming down, you're not doing the bob for the apple, but you're using your triceps, you're using your abs. This time, press back through child's pose, breath in. Breath out, take the hips high to the sky, downward facing dog. Feet nice and wide, pedal through the feet, reach one heel for the ground and the other. And again, this is where I check in with my neck. Often mine is kind of just hanging. You want to lengthen it, of course. And then when you still your down dog, both knees can have a subtle bend so you can press your hips up a little higher to the sky. So here, if I were to adjust and pull your hips up and back, you shouldn't get that, oh, I grew 3 inches. You should already be pushing away so much that you're really already that long. Then maybe the legs can extend a little bit. Take a walk forward with the feet. They can stay hip width apart. Hold behind your head and then let the knees just softly bend and you're just ragdolling here a little bit back and forth. Breath in, breath out. Then begin to still, let your weight shift forward so you feel your abs have to tighten. Then you can fold a little more. Release the arms, roll up through the spine, vertebrae by vertebrae. Bringing the legs a little closer together. The big toe mounds can touch, but I like my heels apart. Inhale to reach the arms up. Exhale to fold forward. Inhale, the knees can bend a little bit wherever you need to, of course, but inhale, lengthen the heart forward. And exhale, step your right leg back. Notice left knee is over heel. Dropping the back knee down. I turn my palms in, reach up, breath in. Crack. Exhale, hands come down. Abs are already tight. Stepping back, downward facing dog. Hold here for breath in, breath out. And then the same foot that you stepped back, so right foot, step it up this time. I'm trying to push with my heels of my hands down into the mat so that my hands don't pop up. Dropping your back knee down. Palms face in, reach the arms up, breath in. Breathe out, take the hands back down. Look a little forward, tighten the abs, and then as your back knee lifts, the leg is stepping up. Inhale to arch. Exhale to fold. Arms go wide to the side to rise. You get taller as the hands come down, heart center, Tadasana. And then again, inhale to reach up. Exhale to fold. Inhale to lengthen. And on the exhale, step the left leg back, lunge. Back knee drops down. Inhale to reach up. Exhale, hands come down. My abs are tight. I push my hands into the floor, downward facing dog. Same leg that went back steps forward, left leg lunge. Back knee drops down. Inhale to reach up. And on the exhale, hands come down. Back leg comes up. Inhale to lengthen. Exhale to fold. Arms go wide to the side to rise. Hands come down, heart center. Adding on. Inhale to reach. Exhale to fold. Inhale to lengthen. Exhale, right leg steps back, lunge. Drop the knee down. Inhale to reach up. On the exhale, abs are tight. You step back, downward facing dog. Adding on a vinyasa. Chin to the chest, roll forward. Shift forward of the wrists, lower either halfway or all the way down on the exhale. Pointing the toes, inhale, chest opens. Notice the triceps, full, back. And then belly to spine brings you back downward facing dog. Right foot steps up between the hands. Back knee drops down. Inhale to reach up. Exhale to fold. Back leg up to front. Inhale to lengthen. Exhale to fold, and arms reach out to come up. Hands come down, heart center. I'm ducking my dining room table here. Inhale to reach, exhale to fold. No excuse. Inhale to lengthen, and exhale, palms down, left leg back lunge. Back knee drops down, arms reach up, breath in. Abs are tight as your hands come down, downward facing dog. Vinyasa, chin to the chest, roll forward. Exhale to lower, elbows are in, toes point, inhale, up dog or cobra, you can be on the ground. And exhale, hips go up to the sky, downward dog. Left leg steps up, back knee drops down, inhale to reach up. And exhale, hands down, back leg reaches up, inhale to lengthen. Exhale to fold, arms go wide to the side to rise. I get taller as my hands come down, heart center, Tadasana. Again. You can repeat one on each side. Notice if your heels of your hands don't easily match the ground, meet the floor, use the blocks. Take the blocks under your hands, just take them out for your vinyasas so that as you're breathing here, moving, the ground is built up to you a little bit easier. You can maybe bend the knees on your down dog. The step forward will be epically easier with the blocks under the hands because you've created some extra space and you can really feel your abs start to grab as you step the foot up between the blocks. So maybe if you're moving around my pace, I've got just one more side left, one more round. I believe this is Surya C, or a variation of. Notice the chest lengthens forward and out, but that you don't rock back on your heels. And moving through your last round here, we'll meet back at the top of the mat. Tadasana, you can just stand there. If you're there before me, take a couple deep breaths. Feel your tail drop down towards the heels. Feel your abs tighten so you feel yourself lengthen up and off the low back. And then everyone can stand there for another breath with the eyes closed and just feel the energy starting to move around a bit. The weight kind of transfers between the feet. Try to find somewhere where you're nice and balanced. Root down and then lift up a little taller. Warrior two. Soften the knees and step the left foot back. Notice your front heel to back arch and the arms can just reach out. A lot of people will be back here. Knee over the front heel. Knee over the middle of the feet. And then as you breathe, you're rolling your shoulders back, but you're also lengthening the sides of your shirt. I don't like to hold lunges. I don't hold them terribly long, but you should stay here maybe 5 breaths. And then keeping the bend in the knee, tip back, reverse the warrior, inhale. Exhale into your side angle. Right arm either side, or of course on a block. And you can take it on the inside of the front leg with the top arm today. Spin the palm forward, reach the fingers overhead, and then just take a few deep breaths. And as I'm breathing, I'm reaching out the top middle finger. I'm pushing down in the outer edge of the back foot so I can feel my inner thigh is really engaged, just lifted. One more breath. And then reach the arm back to the sky. Hands frame the front foot. I'm going to lift my back heel up. And then inhale, extend my front leg. I like my palms to be flat, so some of you might turn the blocks up. We're not too heavy into the block, so you're pulling your abs in. So there's actually a push into the floor, into the block. Breathe out, let the front knee bend. Breathe in, let the leg lengthen. And then again, breathe out, let the knee bend. One more, inhale to lengthen the leg. Feel your hips pull back square. Back heel lift higher. And then on your exhale, you can soften the elbows, fold a little bit more. Maybe reach the arms forward a little, but you don't have to get too aggressive. It's still quite early. Lastly, give the knee a bend. We're gonna come through a side plank. So take your left hand down. The back heel I'm gonna put down to the left. Then I'm gonna creep my right foot out and down. My right arm reaches up. So now I'm pushing the outer edge of my foot down so my hips lift. I might stay or I might stack. Vashisthasana side plank. Shoulder is over wrist, abs are tight, and I can feel the energy go up through my back, up my middle finger, and take another breath. Hover the top leg, and return center plank. Vinyasa. Exhale, hips go high to the sky. Stay for a breath in, breath out. I'm bringing the legs a little bit closer together. High on the balls of the feet, look forward as you bend the knees. And then either walk or think three springs. Hips over the wrists each time. It's gonna give you that kind of nice weightlessness you might use for a headstand later on. Exhale, fold. Inhale, reach the arms wide to the side to rise. And exhale, hands come down to heart center, Tadasana. Opposite side, soften the knees, step the right leg back and you're in your warrior two. And then as you breathe, tighten in your middle so that the sides of the body lengthen. I haven't done any cardio lately. I'm already a little sweaty. I'm already a little tired. Plus I'm talking too. You could always memorize my vocals and then talk while you do it and you're getting double the workout. That's a good 5 breaths or so in your warrior. Left palm up, tip back, inhale. Exhale, side angle, left arm, either side. I like a block or the mat. Notice there's a bit of space under here. So I'm pulled in and up. I'm pushing into the block, squeezing my abs. Top arm rotates and then reaches overhead. Now as you breathe, the counteraction to the reach is this grounding down, the pressing down in the back outer edge of the foot. And so I can feel my butt, left butt, is kind of aiming towards the back heel, so it's a little bit underneath the body. I'm gonna take my gaze down because my neck is a little crampy today. Now we exhale, both hands down.
can take my blocks if I want. Feet about hip width apart. Inhale to lengthen the front leg. Exhale to bend. Inhale to stretch. Exhale to bend. Last one. Inhale, hold the stretch of the front leg. Most people's weight will shift back. So lifting your back heel brings you a little bit up. You lengthen on the inhale and exhale, fold a little bit more. Maybe reach the blocks out. Stay for another breath into the hamstring. And then soften the front knee, coming through side plank. So right hand comes down, right heel takes it down to the right, and you kind of creep this left leg to where it needs to be to let you pull that left hip back and around, stack it over the right hip, potentially. Bottom leg presses down enough, you can stack your feet, and you breathe in your Vashisthasana side plank. Couple deep breaths. Option, squeeze the abs tighter. Hover the top leg just a little bit, not too high. Just lengthen it. And then come through center plank. That was fast. Shift forward, vinyasa. And exhale, find your way to downward facing dog. Legs come a little closer together. High on the balls of the feet. Give the knees a bend. Look forward. And then walk or spring your way to the front. Inhale to lift the heart. Exhale to fold. Arms go wide to the side to rise. Hands come down, heart center. And again, soften the knees. We'll step left leg back, warrior two. Tip back, reverse, inhale. On the exhale, move through your side angle. So find the nice long body, take your gaze to the floor. Left hand stays up. I'm gonna move back so you can see. Right arm reaches forward, either block or mat. And then you can push into the right heel to rise up, Ardha Chandrasana. And then here, just take a few breaths. Notice the back leg. Doesn't have to be super high. My toes are pointing to that wall, to the side, and my abs are super tight. I'm going to stay for one more breath. Take both hands to the mat, square the back toes down. Breathe in to lengthen the back. Breathe out, I bend my front knee. High lunge, arms reach up. Squeeze the inner thighs, lift the chest, arc up, inhale. And on the exhale, hands come down. Step back, either plank or three-point plank. Shift forward, lower halfway, all the way down. Inhale for your up dog or cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. And then take your right foot, sweep it up towards the sky, down dog split. Push into the right fingertips. And then draw knee to the nose, shoulders come forward. Inhale to press it up. Exhale, knee to the nose. Inhale to press it up. And again, exhale, knee to the nose. Stepping the foot up, trying to push the heel of the hand down. Back leg comes up, inhale to lift. Exhale to fold, arms go wide to the side to rise. Hands come down, heart center, opposite side. Right leg steps back, warrior two. Tip back, inhale, reverse. Exhale, come through your side angle. You can stop hand to thigh, hand to the floor. Reach up with the opposite side. And then you're creeping forward into your Ardha Chandrasana. If you push down into the heel, just kind of helps you ground a little bit easier, I think, as you rise up. My back leg is often spinning up and out of control. So I'm going to rein it in. I'm going to rotate it in so I can feel my inner thigh pushing through my heel. I'm squeezing my tummy. Hopefully that's somewhere around where it should be. Take another breath. And then exhale, bring both hands to the floor. Inhale to lengthen the heart, making sure the back toes are down, so it's your modified warrior three. Soften the left knee, high lunge on the breath in. Breathing out, squeeze the inner thighs so you have a lift, and then arc up to go back a little bit. Exhale, hands come down. You can always take hands to the blocks if you want as well. Push down in the mat or the blocks. You hover the heel, you feel your abs as you hit 3-point. Or regular plank. Shift forward. I stop my shoulders at my elbow height, chaturanga. Toes point, inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Careful if your hands are on the blocks. I like to move them there. Left leg, reach up to the sky. Inhale. Exhale, knee to the nose. Inhale to press up. Exhale, knee to the nose. Again, inhale to press up. Exhale, knee to the nose, stepping the foot right up. Back leg follows, inhale to lift. Exhale to fold. Arms go wide to the side to rise. Hands come down, heart center, Tadasana. Adding on, soften the knees, left leg back, your warrior two. Tip back, inhale, reverse. Exhale, you're coming into your Ardha Chandrasana. Try to get there fairly smoothly, fairly seamlessly. This time, bending your top leg, reach back with your left hand and you'll find your ankle. Bendy people's knees are gonna go up. Try to press your knees slightly down so it's almost a right angle at your hip. And now from here, gently start to press your chest forward, pull your toes back, and the imagery is this almost Cheerio dangling from your ceiling. So there is a drop that could happen. A ball could just drop in the circle of your body. Stay there for another breath. I'm already out because I've hit the chair. And then the hands come down to the ground. The leg extends and you're in your modified warrior three. Stay for a breath in. Breath out, start to soften the knee, land in your lunge, rising up to high lunge, inhaling. Exhale to melt down, let your inner thigh squeeze, inhale to arc up and back. And now on the exhale, let your hands come out to the side, thread the right arm onto the left. Wind up either once or twice the arms. And now down with the shoulders, lean forward, you're squeezing, I'll back up a little bit. You're squeezing your belly and your right butt. And I'm gonna kick my left leg forward, cross knee over knee, and then wind up either again once or around completely with my foot. If you just cross the knees, that's fine. Think about the squeeze of the inner thighs, squeeze of the belly, and then melt down. Keep squeezing the inner thighs so you can find your abs and reach your shoulder elbows forward of your knees as you fold and itch. Hopefully you're still balancing. Stay for a full breath here, in and out. To release. Unwind the front leg. Step back, warrior two. Breath in. Tip back, reverse warrior. And then stay there. Extend your front leg on the breath in. Exhale, triangle pose, Trikonasana. Right arm comes down to either your block, shin, foot. And you can take the top arm, spin thumb back. Drop the hand behind the waist, and then you've got your half bind. So looking either up or down, notice you can kind of snuggle that right butt under you again. So you have a nice inner thigh stretch. Stay for a few breaths. Letting your front knee start to bend. Unwrap the arms. Take both feet mat width apart as you step your left leg up to meet your right, and you'll angle your toes out, coming into a little squat. Probably feels good since you're building a little bit of heat on that right butt. So with your chest, you want to puff it up, lengthen it, so that I'm dropped down, but there's a push into the ground. So you're kind of fighting the pull of the gravity as you're here. If your heels aren't down, you'll stuff a little blanket maybe under the heels, or you can roll your mat up and tuck it under your heels, or you can just come up into kind of a sumo squat, hands lightly on the thighs. And then take yourself, fold over the legs. Draw your feet a little closer together. Soften the knees and roll up through the spine. Other side, knees softly bend. Right leg steps back, warrior two. Hit back, reverse, inhale. Exhale, move through the side angle. Reach up with the top hand and hit back up again. And again, you're moving into your Ardha Chandrasana. Back leg doesn't fly away. And so here, you can keep your gaze down. As you start to bend the top leg, try to keep the knee from riding up on you so that when you grab it, you can feel a little slight quad stretch, but you're more of a parallel to the sky feeling with the back chicken wing type leg. And then from there, you can start to press your chest forward. Trust yourself a little bit. Press your toes back into the hand, and you start to bring yourself into this arch. And again, the imagery would be like a dangling Cheerio on its side, like a little inner tube, so that you could drop something straight down from the sky through the inner tube, and you release. Modified warrior three. Inhale, flex through the back foot, cheat, look at it, turn all the toes down. Reach your chest forward, and then soften the front knee. You're going right into your high lunge. Again, a squeeze of the thighs. Inhale to lift the chest. And on the exhale, Bring yourself up first, open the arms, and our left arm goes under the right. Wind up once or twice. Down go the shoulders, you lean forward, and then I'm pushing. My chin is already my knee. So I'm pushing into my left heel to kind of get off the back leg. Crossing at the knees, I squeeze my inner thighs, and I melt down, and I may or may not wrap that bottom foot around the leg. Stay for a few breaths here. Garudasana, eagle pose. This is a good time to check in with that bottom foot. If you can, spread your toes out so that you're not increasing a bunion if there is one in my case, and my toes are relaxed. When you unwind, back to your warrior two. Tip back, inhale. Lengthen the front leg on the next breath in. And then exhale, triangle pose, left arm, either shin, block, or mat. Top arm can turn back, hand behind the back, and snuggle the arm in so you can really roll the collarbone back. Just kind of like we did in the beginning stretch, the half Mukhasana, only it's, depending on your body, it could be a little deeper because my hand's in my hip area, hip crease. Couple deep breaths. And again, I focus on the spread of my toes when I look at them because I'm opening up the bunion area of the foot. But you might have different focus when you're here. Some people's butt likes to pop out. You're bringing the left butt towards the back heel. And you're eventually taking your gaze up to the sky. Stay for another breath. Exhale to release down. Back leg, step it up to meet front. And then again, take your feet hip width apart. So you're going to sit down and you find a squat. Inhale to lift the chest. A few deep breaths. And exhale. Power into your heels. Press yourself up. Reach the arms up. Heel toe your feet together. And then draw your hands by your side. Tadasana. Tree pose. Right foot either calf or inner thigh. I like my hips to stay square. Today, I'm just taking my hands to heart center, and I'm gonna make sure I lift like that so I can feel my thumb almost at my sternum. Collarbones are open, and I'm really focusing on lengthening out of my back. Taking a few breaths, making sure the bottom leg is actively pushing into my foot so there's this tension to get yourself a little bit taller. Tightening in the abs. Give your right knee a little lift. And with the peace signs, you're going to reach in, grabbing your big toe. Left hand, I'm going to take it straight out to the side and a little forward, and then extend through the right heel. As much as you get with stretching the leg, it's fine. If there's a little bend, what's important is that the right hip is dropped, your abs are tight, and maybe you take the full expression with the leg all the way stretched. Stay for another breath. To come out, bend the knee. Drop it down to hip height and bring the leg in front of the body. My left hand grabs the outer edge of the leg. And now again, there's a tension. Hand into leg, leg into hand. I lift, I drop the hip, hopefully. And then I start to reach back. I'm bending my left elbow so that my bicep can take over and I'm not hiking up my shoulder. As you move your gaze to the back, that's where you're gonna start to maybe lose your balance a little, but feel your balance in your abs and your belly. Stay for a breath. As you return, hug the thigh to the chest, apanyasana maybe. And then get taller as your leg comes down to meet the opposite leg, tadasana. Left foot tree pose, foot in towards calf or inner thigh. And then again, abs tighten so you lift up. And just take a few breaths here. Active bottom leg so that you feel this kind of straw sensation corkscrewing you up taller, taller. Be kind of a sucking milkshake through a straw sensation. I don't think I completed that thought. From here, stay tall. Think about the right side of the body. Squeeze your belly. Bend your left knee a little even more and try to lift it. Peace sign the big toe. And then I'm going to reach out through the opposite arm. It's a little forward of the body. I lengthen up and then I start to extend through my leg, through my heel. It presses out, 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 out. Maybe you hit the full expression. Take a few breaths. Notice your hips
are pretty level. But your abs are still super tight. Stay for another one. Then to come out, bending your knee, take it forward, drop it to hip height, keep the elbow a little bit bent, find the tension, and then begin to spiral. So you feel almost a little work in the obliques as you twist towards the back. Maybe tracing your gaze back there as well. So you come out, bring yourself back forward, hug the thigh to the chest, and then release the leg down. Tadasana. Surya B. Sit back and down, Utkatasana chair pose. Exhale, thigh towards the chest. Inhale, lift the heart. And exhale, step back or jump back, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog or cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Taking the right foot, sweep it up between the hands, heels of the hands pressed down as best you can. Back heel down to the left, and then rolling up warrior one on the inhale. Abs are already tight. I lower myself back down, stepping back plank, vinyasa. Meeting in down dog, just for a big breath in. Sweeping your left foot up between the hands, back heel down, rising up warrior one. And falling back down, hands pressed down, plank, vinyasa, back to your downward facing dog, few deep breaths. Trying to breathe in through the nose, out through the nose, that's your best bet towards your Ujjayi breath if you're already there, probably. I'm talking and stuff, so I'm not really doing that. I'm also not pressing my legs out really straight because my hamstrings are a little odd today. So I'm going to keep a little bend, press my hips higher, even though it's in the middle of class, this is what feels better. Stay for another breath. Walk or jump the feet up to the hands. Inhale to lengthen. Exhale to fold. Utkatasana chair pose. Press into the heels, rise up. Go ahead, take one more Surya B. Inhaling back and down, Utkatasana. Exhale, belly to thighs, fold. Inhale to prepare. And on the exhale, either step or jump back. Land bent elbows if you jump. Inhale to take the chest opening. Exhale, belly to spine takes you back, downward dog. Right foot up between the hands, back heel down, warrior one, breath in. Exhale, hands come down, stepping back, vinyasa. Finding your way back, downward facing dog. And then no rush when you get there. Left foot comes up, back heel down. Inhale, arms up, warrior one. Exhale, hands return down, stepping back, plank, last vinyasa here. Meet in your downward facing dog. Take a breath in, breath out, no rush to get there. And when you're ready, walk or jump feet to the front. Inhale to lift the heart. Exhale to fold. Utkatasana chair pose. And then press into the heels to rise. And we'll all meet there in Tadasana again. Just let the eyes close, spreading your toes out. Take a few breaths. Feel the energy again, kind of moving around. If you're still getting there, no rush. And we'll get a little twisty. So Utkatasana chair pose, sitting back and down. Hands come in towards the heart center. The more you squeeze your thighs, the easier it will be to sit and twist. Towards the right you go. I'm going to lock it in with my tricep on my thigh. Pull back with my left hip. So I'm mostly squaring with the hips as I take my twist. And take a couple deep breaths here. You could always open the arms. I believe that would be full expression. I like to keep hands at heart center and just keep my hips a little lower than my heart so I can lengthen and breathe. Exhale to fold, let legs extend and bend. And again, sit down, Utkatasana chair pose. Hands come heart center and take your twist to the left. A few deep breaths when you get there. Now it's the opposite hip pulling back. So I feel the right hip pull back, my hips stay square, my legs squeeze, and I stay for one more breath. Release out, inhale, stretch the legs, exhale, give them a bend. Crow pose. Now if you have your blocks, you can bring them together, and you can step your feet right onto them. This is a little easier to get into the crow pose because your feet are elevated here. So hands, point your fingers face forward. I'm going to squeeze my knees in, and my hands just are right under the shoulders.
I look forward and I find chaturanga. So right now I'm pretty heavy into my arms. But if I squeeze my arms in, my knees in on my arms, pulls my arms in, I squeeze my tummy and I point one toe and the other and then I'm there. Now the work is kind of dropping the butt a little so you can dome in your back or squeezing your tummy. Everything tightens up. Stay there roughly, four breaths if you can. And when you come out, just take a little rest, reaching your butt back. Pull the abs in, reach your arms forward, your head forward. You can still be in your crow if you're there. Otherwise, meeting, taking a few deep breaths. Side crow. Knees bend. Find your knees, hips facing front. And now from here, turn with your chaturanga style arms. Turn to the right. And immediately off the bat, you're finding this twist. I'm going to cheat the first side. I'm going to shelf with my triceps, that whole right side femur. As I look forward, I want my shoulders to be in chaturanga. So one can't be up and the other down. You have to find hands down, a deep twist. You look forward, and hopefully my shoulders are pretty even as I lift the feet right off of the blocks. Now, you would stay and breathe a few breaths. Of course, I'm coming out of it because I'm tired. Taught like 4 classes today. Deep twist, watch the shoulders don't dip below the elbows and watch that they're pretty even. When you're finished with that side, come center, take a breather, take a breath. You can rest your heels down and let's do the other side. Now, if not cheating, you're gonna make a shelf. You're twisting towards the left, you're gonna shelf with your right hand. The left hand is mirroring the right arm. There's nothing touching the elbow. So as you look forward, I find chaturanga. My hips are kind of in the middle, it's almost like a little triangle. And I lift my toes right off the floor. It's all your body weight, so it probably builds a bit of heat. Have fun there. Take a couple breaths. Put me on pause if you need to and practice that a bit. And when we meet, we'll be sitting down. Dandasana. Hips under the shoulders. Knees can have a little bend if that feels better for your body. And then the inhale is a lift up through the heart. Exhale. Take your hands and press the heel of the hand down so your shoulders glide down your back. Just taking a few breaths here. Notice if your legs can't be straight, that's fine. Feet are pressing forward evenly, so the inner ball of foot presses outward. And then as you start to fold forward, if it feels better, give the knees a little bend so you can hug the legs, fall down onto the legs, or you can reach for the toes, the feet, the outer edges of the feet. Dropping the elbows. Just folding forward. Paschimottanasana. Inhale, feel the chest pull forward a little. Exhale to melt down a little deeper. And rolling up nice and slow. I slide my hands back from my hips. My pointer fingers face forward. Chin to the chest. I'm going to attempt to go up with straight legs. Hips lift, I get a little stretch on the arms, I feel my butt, I feel my abs, I might stay. Or if it hurts my back, I'm going to take tabletop, feet hip width apart, pushing my hips up. I look for my knees because I want them to disappear. I want my hips to go up so much that I see my thighs, maybe a little bit of belly, and not so much of the knees. Take a breath wherever you are and land the hips back down. And when you get there, open the legs to find straddle stretch. This, if you're really tight, you might want to sit up onto something. And if you're okay flat, grounded down, you can start to press your hips forward from behind a little bit. Pop, pop, pop. Press out through the feet. And then only if it feels good, you can start to fold forward. I like it a little bit more restorative. So I've got my blocks. I catch my ribs. And then I catch my head. And I'm just going to take a few breaths there. There's an inner thigh stretch happening. If I burpee down my feet, press through the ball of the foot, I can feel my quad lengthen, which is a nice kind of action. I might drop this block down a little more, and I'm just breathing into my inner thighs, relaxing the rest of me. As you breathe, notice the hip points are still pressing back and down, so you're grounding down the back side of you. Checking where we are in class with my playlist. Stay for a few more breaths. And begin to roll up nice and slow. Feet can come a little closer together. Take a butterfly. Holding the ankles, lift up on the inhale. And the heels are quite far from your center so that you can just release forward and over the legs. I like to thread my arms through and kind of cradle the outer edges of my feet as I fold. Stay there, take a few more deep breaths. In studio class where I would say take your mat to the wall, maybe practice some handstand work. I do actually have space here, so we could conceivably do that. Let's do it. Mat, if you have wall space, we'll go against a wall and handstand prep. So there's a few options here. We could start, if you're not afraid and you're at home, the owl shake. My butt goes against my wall. I'm one leg's length away from the wall, so I can flex my feet. Knees might be bent, that's okay. Wherever my heels are, there goes my block. So now, I put my hands where my heels were. It's about your knuckle line in there. They're about shoulder width apart. I'm gonna pop up into like my mini down dog. I'm gonna look forward so my chest is opening. I take my foot hip height, so you don't want it way up, hip height. And these are nice walls. I feel bad using them for this. You're gonna push both feet into the wall, press your heels into the wall. I'm still looking forward, and as I extend my legs, you should stay there. I don't wanna muck up my wall. Your hips are gonna be right over top of your wrists. So if seen from the side, you would be in a little L shape. Now this can be hard. If your feet start to slide down the wall, I think it's a weakness in your core personally, or your upper arms, your upper body. So you can work in the L shape for quite a long time before you can hold yourself there and you're not slipping down the wall, because you're actually holding with your hips over your shoulders, over your wrists, holding with your abs. If you're already down, don't worry. Either try again, or you could turn around and take a puppy dog with the knees a little bit bent, heels under your hips. I don't want to move the camera. Hands come about maybe the height of your ears, biceps by ears. And there's a push into the wall. There's a squeeze in your abs, so you're actively in your L shape. You're just on your legs instead of your hands. Lastly, of course, is your handstand. You're looking towards your wall. Your hands are down about a foot away from the wall. Now I step my dominant leg in. The opposite leg is not a swing. It's actually flexed, and my abs are tight. And then this bottom leg is gonna spring me off the floor and get you up in your handstand. So again, you can of course try that. I'm here in my house, I don't want to muck up my walls, so I'm going to opt out of the handstand. When you're done all of that, take your time. Take it down to the knees, and we're going to reverse the flexion in the wrists. So no rush getting there if you want to give it a couple more goes. When you're ready, knees under hips, and just very lightly start to roll out the top of the wrist. Make sure you do both sides. And then have a seat. Feet are hip width apart. And you'll tuck your tail. You'll lean a bit back. You can support with the hands on the thighs if you need to. Pulling my abs and making C shape. And I'm going to go up an inch and down. Down an inch and up. Up an inch and down. Down an inch and up. The trick is that you're pulling in, you're keeping this C shape in your back. We're not gonna be in the C shape for that much longer because we're headed down to the ground. One inch up and then one inch down. Then you're still going, but I'm gonna readjust my mat so you can see from the side. Plus I've already done this one about four times today. Last four, three, two, tuck your tail, release down to the back, nice and slow, nice and easy. Feet come a little bit closer together. And on your inhale, lift the hips up, finding bridge. I like to shimmy my shoulders under. I'm gonna look straight up at the ceiling so I don't hurt my spine at all. and then pushing down with the arms quite actively into the mat. Stay for another 3-4 breaths. Hopefully you've turned on some music. I can hear myself breathing heavily. Should do some cardio. Release the arms, tuck your tail, lower down with control. And again here, give yourself a full breath in, full breath out. On the inhale, go ahead, lift the hips and either come back to where you were or your hands can come by your ears. I like my fingers turned out sometimes if my shoulders are tight. Fingers turned towards heels, proper, onto the head. Exhale, extending your arms and you've got your back bend. Urdhva Dhanurasana, not to be confused with wheel. When you're good, tuck your tail, tuck your chin to your chest rather, and then roll down with control. I like to roll out my wrists and windshield wiper the knees side to side, nice and easy. Finding happy baby. So both heels kick up to the sky, grabbing either the hamstrings or the outer edges of your feet. Let your hips press down into your mat so that you can retraction your spine. And your breath, just relax. Natural inhale, natural exhale. And then bringing soles of the feet to the mat. Snuggling your shoulder blades under the body. Palms can be up, and then let your feet extend out and forward if it feels okay for your back. You can also butterfly the feet, opening the knees, and as you're here in your Shavasana, just start to let your tongue release from the mouth so that it's not grounding you down at all. You have no sensation there. Tongue separate from mouth, from teeth. As you breathe, just trying to relax more and more of the skin between the eyes. So feeling free to just stop everything. If you need to just pause this and take a few minutes just to lay there, go for it. Otherwise, start to deepen the breath, wiggling the fingers, toes, you can circle the ankles, circle the wrists. And then there's hopefully room behind you. You can stretch the arms overhead, get a nice stretch. And on the exhale, the arms can come by the sides, feet onto the mat, grounding yourself down. Take another breath in. Breathing out, rolling onto the right side. Zero rush, keeping the head kind of angled down. Press yourself up with the left hand. Your head will be the last thing to come upright. Hands can either be thighs or heart center. Notice that you are even front to back and even left to right. On your exhale, let your shoulders drop. On your inhale, lift your heart. And keeping an open heart, bow chin into the chest. Namaste. Thank you for practicing, for hanging out. Hopefully you liked. If you didn't, feel free to shoot me a message. If you did, feel free to share it with somebody. Have a good rest of your day or night or whatever else is happening. And happy... Well, it's a happy... I don't know what day it is. It's a happy Tuesday. Bye-bye.